guys, got this Wrangler right here up on the frame to get the frame rail straight. So what I have to do now is I gotta disconnect all these lines around this bar right here. All this wiring, everything around here has to come off. Still has some coolant in there. And also I have to disconnect right here that bolt right there, because that connects to the drive, I don't know if you call it drive shaft, the differential to the front. So when I pull it, nothing moves with it, just the rail. And after I take off everything off this bar, I'm gonna have to get it cut right here and right here, just to separate this rail from this rail. So I could pull each one separately and get it straight. Like you can tell from right here, everything shifted over right there. And they're at an angle. Thank you. Okay, I got the Wrangler lining up pretty good. So up next, I gotta put on the radiator support from here to here. And then see how that sits with the frame and these rails on each fender. Let me show you guys how the hood is sitting right now. Sitting pretty good from this side. This side, the fender needs to come out a little bit, but because it doesn't have this latch right here, and it has a rubber piece that sits between these two to make the hood sit a little higher. Well, it's looking pretty good. And this is the radiator support that I'll be putting on. And that's the cooling system in those two boxes. And this is the harness, the horns, and the sensors that go on this radiator support. Okay guys, got it off the frame. Up next is finishing the suspension off. We got the Rubicon shocks coming in on this one. No lift kit, we don't know yet, maybe. Oh, we got some big wheels coming on it. Either 33 or 35 inch tires. All right, see you next time.